There's something very interesting about goal setting. And in this video, I want to share few very interesting ideas. So I'm going to answer these four questions. Okay. Why set goals? Number two, why people set goals on some important occasions? Number three, what are fruit goals and root goals? Number four, why people fail in their New Year resolutions and setting goals. Okay, with that said, let's get into the video. Why should we set goals? What purpose does a goal serve? Because there are many people who never set goals, but yet they have achieved good success. So why should we set goals? I think in today's world, it is more pertinent. See, goal setting is a tool. And any tool, how good it would be, depends on how do we utilize it. There is a foreground and background. When I say goal setting is good, there is some context to it. When I say goal setting is not required, there is another context to it. So what does this goal setting do? What this tool helps us? First thing, it helps us in overcoming distractions. In today's world, it is even more relevant because the biggest companies in the world, they are trying everything to grab your attention. I have mentioned it many times. We are in attention economy. Your Google, your Facebook, or Meta, or your Instagram, Amazon, Apple. Look at all these companies. They are one game. They are into one game, and that is game of human attention. How do I get more human attention? And no surprise, most people look distracted because of these gadgets and many other things in life. So goal is a tool which helps us in managing these distractions. Because naturally, please understand, human brain naturally, what is our main tuning? Our brain is primarily made for making us survive. Survival is the first goal of our brain. Thrival is not the first goal. Survival. Somehow I survive. Therefore, it is always scanning for possible threats. And when it is scanning for possible threats, it sometimes, because of this continuous scanning, gets attracted towards many things which are not threats, but which makes us feel good. And in this process, most people find it very difficult to maintain their priorities. We end up doing what is more interesting, what is likely to give us immediate result, what is likely to make me happy now, above what is more important. So urgency supersedes importance. Urgency supersedes importance. That means I tend to do those things which appear urgent to me at the cost of giving up my important things. That's the whole game. So in goal setting, what happens is we operate from a higher center. It gives us ability to look beyond, look little far, look little away from now and here. And therefore, it enables our higher centers in our brain to overcome this tendency for falling up short-term pleasures. It helps us to overcome, it helps us to postpone our gratification. And that's a well-established fact that our ability to postpone gratification is one of the key things when it comes to achieving success in life. So your goals will help you. Hello everyone. Please keep your comment for some time. Once I complete, I would certainly respond to your comments. Thank you so much. So now the question comes, why goal setting? And the first answer, first reason is it helps you overcoming your distraction because our mind is primarily looking for survival, not for thrival. Our mind is looking for what is now and here, and it is not naturally trained to look far. Therefore, if we need to really do something significant, it requires focused attempt for long term, and goal setting is a tool to help that. The second reason what goal does, thank you. The second reason what goal does is, the goal of the goal is to give you a plan. The goal of the goal is to give you a plan. That's the only goal of a goal. Okay. Once the plan comes, what happens? Once you develop plan, it helps you developing clarity. So the second purpose which goals serve is, it gives you clarity. And higher clarity gives you little higher surety. Okay, it increases your certainty of action. That's the second purpose of goal setting, which goal setting serves. It helps us overcoming our tendency to do things which I like, which are going to make me feel good, to do those things which are right. Second, it helps us to develop a clear sense of direction and also to create a plan. And once the plan is made, actually plan becomes your goal. Diligent action on everyday basis, if I have to take, how will it come? It will come only by plan. So a person who plans can avoid so many mistakes. And therefore, these are two reasons I have given, not to make this video too long. I'll keep it only up to 2 points. Now comes the second question. Second question which I wanted to answer is, because this was asked to me, that why do people feel like setting goals on occasions like New Year, birthday, Diwali, Christmas, or Eid, or some significant moment? Why do they do this? So here is the reason. See, whenever there is a significant break in time and space, when I say break, what I mean is, whenever you can clearly see a new time frame beginning, or you go to a new location, your mind perceives it as a new beginning. Whenever there is a significant break, so December is over now, January has started, 2021 is over, 22 has started, therefore people think that, okay, now I will start fresh. This happened, just remember, when you were in school and in the beginning of the year, when you started your writing in your new notebooks, first page, look at your handwriting on those first couple of pages and look at your handwriting at the later part of the notebooks. Usually, it will be very neat on first few pages because it's a new notebook. We want to start fresh. We want to look, make it look good. That's why every time in the beginning of our year, from class 7th, if I move to class 8th, I thought class 8, I will not do all the mistakes which I did in class 7th. I would start and prepare from day 1. If somebody gets a new job, then also same thing happens. In this company, in this new city, in this new house, we will do a fresh beginning. So, why this is happening? This is happening because your mind can see a clear difference between what was early and what was now. And this helps your mind to let go the past and start fresh. This is only psychologically how we feel. Otherwise, this next second is the first second of rest of your life. This next hour, tomorrow, is the first day of rest of your life. Yes? So there is no difference between that first second which came on New Year Eve after 12 a.m. versus that second which is going to come right now. There is no difference. They are as unique, because even this second which has just gone by, it will never come again in the history. It is as unique as the first second of year 2022. Yes, no? But psychologically, it's a hack that whenever there's a clear division in time and space, our mind can see things with more clarity, and therefore, it is easy for us to start fresh because it helps us to let go of the past. The moment you let go of the past, it gives you new energy. For a moment, just close your eyes and think. Think, imagine if you were just born today with all your present maturity. How would you like your life to be? Imagine if you thought your past has to be forgotten and now onwards you will start fresh. Just this thought gives you a feeling of enthusiasm that I'm going to start fresh now. That's why people do this. So that's the answer for second question. Now third question, rather an interesting thought which I often teach even to my mentees and all, is what is the difference or how many goals should we set? People often ask. I tell there are two fundamental varieties of goals. First variety is called root goals. Visualize an image, a picture of a tree. Root goals. Visualize the root of a tree. Root goals. Second kind of goals are called fruit goals. Now, what's the difference? Root goals are ever relevant. A tree has to keep on growing its root to become strong, to go into search of more and more food, to get a little more confident when it has to handle that next storm, to give more and more nutrition to its stem and leaves. So that is called root goals. There are few things in life which are always relevant for a child, for an adult, for an elderly person. They are always relevant. So goals which help us growing our roots are called root goals. Fruit goals are rather seasonal, which depend on which stage of life we are. So what are root goals? For example, one of the root goals could be health. Whether he or she is a child or an adult or an elderly person. It is simple that if a person is willing to work or become efficient, then we have to sharpen our tool, and our body is the greatest gifts. It is our greatest gift. So everybody must have this one fundamental goal, which is I have to keep myself fit. I have to look my best. I have to see that every year I try to keep my body as healthy as possible. This is a fundamental root goal. So there could be many such root goals. Okay, another root goal could be good relationship or developing in your knowledge and skills. They are always relevant. Becoming emotionally more mature, improving your intellectual ability, developing right network. These are all root goals in a way. Now comes fruit goals. Fruit goals are seasonal. For a student, it could be academics. For a person who has grown up or who is having an employment, maybe career. For a businessman, maybe his business, maybe finances. Okay, maybe name, fame. It depends. It depends on what stage of your life you are. You also set fruit goals. So there has to be some root goals which are always running in the background because it keeps you solid. A healthy body is always going to help you, whether it's a businessman or a sportsperson or a person or a student, doesn't matter. A healthy body will help you, and therefore that's a default goal. That's why I call it root goal. Good relationships help us because our relationships, how well we are connected with the world, it is the single most important factor which decides our overall wellness. Okay, well-established fact in a very good study. So, how do we set these root goals and fruit goals? We have to think about that. Okay. Now comes one more interesting question. And after that, if there are any more questions from your side, I would take after that. So, one more interesting question comes that why people fail? Why so many people set goals? Although in today's world, lesser and lesser people are setting goals because they are taking it as if it will make them feel bad, you know, if they are not able to execute it. And because of that, people think, you know, many people say it to me that if I plan, I will not do it. And then I feel bad, therefore better not plan. Okay, so people have all kind of reasons. So now the question comes, how, why people fail to achieve or to really pursue their resolutions for a long time. The reason is simple. Most people, when they set goals, number one, they do not spend enough time in deciding their goals. I see many people at the first instance, they set irrelevant goals. Okay, goals has to be relevant to your stage of life. And if goals are externally driven, anything which is externally driven is not going to last for long. Goals have to be internally driven. If I want to buy a car because I have to make other people feel that I'm an achiever, it's an external reason for me to buy a car. And within few days of buying, I'm not going to feel happy. If I want to improve my English fluency because I want to impress people, this is an external motivation. I would enroll, I would start doing something, and later on, I'm not going to pursue it. That's why many people start things and then they leave it in middle because battery gets discharged. Yes. Until unless they get that next challenge. You know, somebody in they see in the office is getting advantage because of his communication skill. Now this person thinks, oh, I must build my communication skill. And once that enthusiasm wanes off, once again, the same lazy attitude of not doing anything but only talking about the problem. That's why majority of the people remain problem talkers. They keep on talking problems. They keep on asking tips from everyone. Everyone gives them tip. There's no dearth of people who give tips, right? So many people are there. So much is there on internet. They know they have the resources, but they do nothing because their motive is not clear. It is an externally driven. That's reason number one. Reason number two, most people do not get clarity in their plan. They are not very clear, very specific in the nature. You must have heard about SMART goals. They do not follow those fundamental things. If I do not define my goal, if I do not write it, if I do not create a mechanism to remain enthusiastic about it, to create a visualization plan, to create an affirmation plan, if I don't do that, obviously, my environment, I'll choose wrong environment and it will not help me. Okay? If my environment is not in alignment to my goals, I'm not going to do it. Remember this, your environment will always beat your willpower. Okay? Most people choose a wrong environment and then they blame that, oh, I don't have willpower. Willpower is a limited asset. Unless you're really internally driven, it's not going to last long. So these are few reasons, not being specific, being externally driven, not being very solid in their desire. There's no integrity of intention at the first stage only. I want to achieve something, but I don't want to give what it takes. For years, people have been complaining, my communication is weak, my English is weak, or my health is weak. For years, any reason is usually valid only for a few weeks, few months, maybe a couple of years. After that, every reason starts becoming invalid. If I had a health problem today and it keeps on happening regularly, then there is something which I should have done, which I'm not doing. If today I have my challenge of language, maybe English or some other language or some art or some other skill, and if I keep on complaining about this, even in 23, 24, 25, year 24 and 25, then it's not now problem of my background that I come from a small town, nobody speaks in English. All those excuses become null. They become invalid because you have not taken enough action. So think about that I will not remain a problem talker, but remain a solution seeker. And for that, we need integrity of intention. That means when I am designing something, when I am deciding something, at that time, I am accepting what it takes. Mentally, I am taking this clarity that if this is the goal I have decided and this is the plan for it and this is what it will take. There is a cost for everything. When I say cost, it could be in terms of money, it could be in terms of effort, it could be in terms of giving up some other pleasurable activities. There is no take. There is always give and take. And when I say integrity of intention, most people intentionally not accepted. They have not accepted that I have to give something in order to achieve something. I want to achieve. I want guarantee for everyone, but I don't want to give even guarantee of my action taking. That's the primary reason most people fail. And once integrity of intention is not there, obviously they are not going to be very specific. Obviously they are not going to talk about their action plan in clarity. With that, let's stop here. Thanks a lot.